Welcome to another video on the Traxxas TRX 4M. We have a new mod, the steering parts, the knuckle and the C-shaped holder. We are going to exchange them for full metal ones. The benefit is they are a bit heavier and they put more pressure on the front tires. By default, the steering knuckle over here and the C-shaped holder are from plastic, which is okay, but well, just for fun I like it to be metal, and it is a little bit heavier. So this is the parts, these are the parts that we're going to put in, the metal C-shaped and a metal knuckle, and the four screws and two rings, they come with the package. I ordered this at AliExpress for, I don't know, very little money. So this is what the end result will look like, and as you can see, it is a bit rough over here. That is because I had to do something special. The parts are powder coated, and well, they are very tight tolerances for the brass bushings that we need to place in here, the bushings that come out of the original plastic parts, and that is just 1/10 of a millimeter too small thanks to that powder coating. So what I did with a Dremel, I just used the Dremel, yeah, not by hand of course, but with the Dremel itself, to take away that powder coating here on the inside of all the three places where a bushing needs to be put. And also here on top and here inside the C-shaped, that that also was a little bit stiff. So take away a little bit of the powder coating and then put some silicone grease on there, and it will just rotate very smoothly. In order to reach the screws that we need to take out, we first have to remove the wheel. I just mounted these metal wheels, but if you still have the plastic ones, that of course works the same. Take off the wheel and then take off this nut, and in my case then, this is how I remove the nut. I don't use that jig that came with the TRX 4M. I have my own hex nut remover, and that works a bit nicer. That orange part is my wheel holder. We take that off, and then we have this plastic hex nut. Sometimes that can be a little bit sticky, so you have to push it or use a metal part to take it off. And then there is this metal rod, and please take care that you do not lose that. If that's lost, then your wheel won't rotate anymore. Right now we have access to all the bolts that we need to remove. There are three of them to remove the knuckle. First we remove the steering jig, and then the two screws of the knuckle, and that is done in this way. Take a screwdriver and remove that steering link screw. That's a long one. And then we have the top and bottom screws. This is the top one, this is the bottom one. And that will take off the complete knuckle with the axle, and just pull it out and then put it aside, and we now have access to the screws of the C-shaped mount. Here we clearly see this bushing that rotates the axle. And well, just take out those screws also, and then that part should come off, and then we have these metal, these plastic parts over here, and we are going to change them for the metal parts. This is the metal knuckle. This is the part that came off, and we now have to take out this bushing that is done with a piece of metal. Just push it out, and then this one has to go over there, and I dremeled away that black powder coating so that it now fits in there. And if I had not taken away that powder coating, I simply could not get it in. It has to fit really snugly in that hole. Right now it's time for the larger bushing, and that's this part over here. And the only way to take that out was to use, in my case I used a steel plier, just apply some pressure, and in a couple of moves it should be able to come loose. And there it is. And now this one has to be pushed in there. And again, that is a very tight fit, so you really have to push hard and keep it straight. And then sorry for the blurry image, it did not focus right, but you get the idea. Okay, then we have the C-shaped part. This is the plastic one that just came off. This is the metal one that we are going to put in. It's just a bit heavier, and I like it to be heavy metal. This is the bushing that we also have to push out. And then we have it in our hand, and then we can push it in over there. And what I then did, take the original Traxxas silicone grease and put a little grease inside those bushings. Just a little. If it is a thin film, it is very nice and slippery. If it is too much, then it rather is sticky, and that's not what we want. Just a thin film of silicone grease that will do the job. Once greased a little, then we can put the axle in the large bushing, and we can now mount the C-shaped part just with those two screws, the new screws that came with it. And maybe you can also use the old screws, but there were a couple of screws that came with the unit, so I used those new screws. Here you can clearly see again that I dremeled away the powder coating also on the inside to make the rotation of the knuckle easier. Then there were large long screws that came with the unit, but it turned out it was a little bit too long, so I decided to use the original screw, which was a little bit shorter. And we have two of these short screws with two small rings. Don't lose them, because you have to put them on those screws. And those are the screws that hold the knuckle, and that ring is there because that needs to be able to rotate in there. The original screws had the ring sort of on the screw itself. It was one part. Here it is two parts. So, but put this all together, and then we get this final result. And I can't say it looks nicer, but it's because if the wheel is on, you can't even rather see it. But it is metal, it's a bit heavier. Time to put the wheel back on, and the first step is to place back this little metal rod. That is the one where the plastic hex nut is pushed on so that it rotates with the axle. In my case, I used a little washer for spacing of my orange wheel holder, and that wheel holder is then of course tightened with the hex nut, which in the meantime has come off and on so many times that it even starts to wear a little. And then in my case, I have these little plastic pieces that I put on at the right spot to prevent wheel wobble. If I place my wheel on, this plastic keeps it straight. Well, this is it. Let's have a little video of the car driving. Maybe see you back in the next video, where we are now going to place wheel weights on the rear wheels, because we have now added quite a few grams of extra weight on the front tires. We are also going to have some extra weight on the rear tires. Maybe see you back there, and in the meantime, have fun.